Hi, welcome to Listen Geek. We are...
Go Ninja, go Ninja, go!
Right. Hi, welcome to Listen Geek. I'm Alan.
I'm Dave.
And we'll be playing Ninja All-Stars.
By Soda Pop Miniatures and Ninja Division. It's for 2 to 4 players and takes about an hour or so.
Yeah, let's go on with the game. Or the unboxing first. Right. What do we get in the box? This is a limited edition Kickstarter box that David owns. Or David got.
Yeah.
And got it at the same time.
Yeah. When you kickstarted it, you had an option between getting the basic guys.
Could be some time, sorry.
The basic Ninja Clans. And choosing between some more specialist clans. So you'll see in here you've got...
These are the things, yeah. Tokens and stuff.
Tokens and...
I'm just going to open it because I'm not going to that mean to David again. And then I'm going to... Oh, no, David. And then I'm going to...
It's just not cool, man. Not cool.
Different plans.
Spent ages doing that.
Look, big things. What are these, David?
They are the sort of trophies for tournaments and stuff. Oh, giant golden ninja.
Lots of miniatures.
Yep, extra getting characters, centuries,
and
lanterns, shrines,
big
loads of cards.
More cards.
Cards for other games.
Things. Oh, what is all this?
Loads of stuff in there.
Oh, manual. Oh my god, I can't get it all in. Manuals and score pads and...
You've then got your reference sheets.
Reference sheets for different clans, I imagine. Boards! Is this where you hide things behind?
No, these are where you put scores and where you put the injured guys and so on.
I can't, there's too much.
It doesn't all fit on the screen.
Fit on the, I can't, that can, that I'll try. That might disappear. I'll just put that one there as well. Just keep putting, oh no.
And then you have to be very careful with the board.
I won't open that because it looks a bit risky. We'll do that. We'll see that in a minute. And there's the back of the box. It's very pretty, the back of the box. Very sort of Donkey Kong.
Yeah.
Wah, 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 wah. And then there's more stuff. And things, and stuff, and things, and tokens, and counters, and all the things.
There's a lot of stuff.
It's got quite a high-ish price point, but again, you're getting a lot of stuff in the box. I think it's all good. Right, I think that's enough of the unboxing-y things. You see all the things you get,
and
we will move on to the game.
On to the game.
Hi, David is going to try and explain the rules now, because my mind is blown. Go.
So, to start with, we're going to explain just the basic enough rules so that as we start playing you don't get confused, and then you'll see the rest of the rules as we go along. So each model either has a small base which takes up one spot or a large base which takes up four spots. When moving, you need to take account of any symbols inside the circles you move onto. So for example, this spot here is elevated. It would cost me 3 movement to move up onto an elevated space and only 1 movement to move off of it. When you're elevated, you can see around further and you can see over people and obstacles. So you'll see as we play the game how this works exactly. But just to know that elevated positions, as they sound, give you a better ability to shoot people. Now, any rough terrain or water spaces, so spaces like this and this, will cost you 2 to move into. They will also, the bushes and things, have special effects with an ability called stealth. Now, stealth works by allowing a character which can't be seen at the end of its movement by an opponent, or end of its activation, sorry, by an opponent, to be able to go into stealth. It gains one of these little tokens. This game has loads of tokens. But it gains one of these little tokens, which means that it cannot be seen or affected by the enemy's abilities. You can't draw a line of sight to it, but you can draw a line of sight through it. Effectively, it just disappears. And then if you do an action, which in your next activation... which is other than a stealthy action, you're probably going to lose stealth and therefore your opponents can now see you. The real benefit of stealth is it gives you a bonus when attacking someone because they didn't realise you were there. You basically get the jump on them. So you will see us do that a lot. Other than that, you get to activate one of your models, and to do so you will move it. And you can choose not to move it, it's up to you. And then you'll perform another action. That other action can be to use an ability to make an attack, or to move again, which is a run. Now, I'm not going to go into how we attack, because we'll do that as soon as we get round to it. But just to know that when we deploy, we're deploying to any zone which has little arrows around the corner. So in a moment, we'll deploy, and then you'll see that we'll have gone to those spaces. But when you play, you'll see that there's little arrows at the edges of the circles. Those are the spaces you can deploy. You always deploy opposite each other, as where possible. If there's 3 players, you'd deploy with three players on adjoining sides, and then there'll be one open side. The lanterns are placed at the start of the game. We've already placed them. Any character that moves within one space of a lantern loses stealth. There are loads of other abilities, which you'll see as we go along. And what we're aiming for in this mission is to knock each other out. So the first player to get to 6 victory points for knocking out the players will win. You get 1 point for anyone that's not a tune-in, which is your leader character. And if your opponent knocks out your tune-in but with a non-tune-in model, they will get 2 points. So hopefully it should be nice and quick and brutal. The only other thing you need to understand is that there will be a starting phase where we will get to determining initiative, so who gets to activate first, and then that player will get to choose between drawing extra cards and moving people out of the healing house and putting people back onto the board first. But you'll see that as we play. Effectively, all you really need to know is these are the spaces we move. We use these dice, which have affinity symbols on them, which mean that you're looking for your symbol when you roll to be successful for tests. And when you fight in combat, we'll get round to that in a minute because it's very complicated.
Yes.
Okay. Let's give it a go.
Let's deploy.
So Alan has initiative. We did that by making an affinity test each. He rolled far more of his wind symbol than I rolled of my spirit. So now he gets to activate the first model.
So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yep. So because you moved into the water space. Now you
activate.
Yep. You can choose to either run again, move again.
Oh, I get two actions.
Yeah, so you've got a move and then you've got an action. So because you're there, you are in line of sight of me, so you can't go stealthy. So if you moved to there and stopped.
Okay.
You can go stealthy as well. So I'll give you one of these.
Stealthy?
Yeah. Are your attacks stealthy?
No. Nope.
No. Good. Mine are. So I'm going to activate one of these chaps. And he's going to go. He's got a movement of 6. So he can go 1, 2, 3, 4. And then run. In his turn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Am I in your line of sight there? So the way line of sight works is you simply draw a line between the centre of the two dots. And so what I'm looking for here is the line of sight blocked between there and there?
I think the answer is no, it's not.
No, so if I go back there, am I? Or if I go back here? I will be there, won't I? Because you've got to go through this. I know I'm elevated. I'm going to go here then. I'll stay where I was.
Okay.
And I'll go stealthy.
Okay.
Now, my guys have a stealthy attack, which means as long as I can stay away from the lanterns, I can shoot at him with immunity. He'll have to come over and do a test, a stealth test to get me.
Yeah.
So, what next, sir?
I am going to go 1, 2, 3, 4.
You can run, remember, so you can take another movement.
5.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to go 1, 2, 3.
Yep.
4, 5, 6. I'm going to stay there.
You got a movement of 5.
5.
Okay.
Activated.
He's activated. So, which case I'm probably
Where's
going
your
to.
Activated marker?
Sorry.
Unbelievable. You're green as well, are you?
That's the activated marker.
Ah, okay.
Green is an activated marker. I'll pop it on top of that so I know they go together. Yeah, he's going to run over to there instead.
Okay.
So, the way he did that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah.
And I think I can be seen. So, I'm going to simply pop that on there. Now, the reason I can be seen is because her influence zone is there, so she can draw a line of sight across there. My influence zone is here. All of this stuff on the floor is ignored. So given that she can draw a line which is within her influence zone and elevated, and within my influence zone and elevated, she can see me. Which is not great, because I want to go stealthy.
Because he ignores terrain, difficult terrain.
Yep.
You
can go in here and become stealthy because no one can draw a line of sight to you.
To be fair, no one can draw a line of sight to me here either.
No, no. I'm saying whilst you're stood on there.
I'm going to go stealthy.
I'm going to go stealthy. Pop it on his base. Seeing as they have a large enough base to do so. Right. There, let's go stealthily.
Yep. Do I not activate. Have line of sight?
No, because you have to draw it through there. Yeah.
Yes, you're correct, David.
If I stood on it, then you'd be good. Come closer, little green man.
Can you move your own miniatures?
I don't believe so. I think all miniatures block.
Not really matters. Oh, I can run, can't I?
Yeah, if you want.
No, go stealthy.
Gonna go stealthy. Right. Oh, you're causing me concerns. Let's send Medushi over that way.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is riveting stuff in the first turn.
Yeah. Lots of running at things. Right.
I might as well just face the corner. Cool.
Activate.
Activated. Everyone's done. So, at the end of this round, we haven't managed to attack or hurt anyone. But we then go back to the start of the round. So, the upkeep phase. We play our upkeep. So, we play a game of rock, paper, scissors, but we don't like doing that. We roll our affinity test. So, I've got
one.
None of mine, and you've got one. So, you get to have an initiative. So the first thing you need to do is to choose... so you move the...
So the activate markers come off?
Yeah, take all your activation markers off. So you get to move one friendly model from the healing house, but you don't need to. Remove activation tokens, then perform one of following actions. You can either draw one moon card. You can then have one additional friend... Yeah, that moves around.
Which way?
Towards you. That's it. Yeah, one additional friendly model move from the healing house to training ground. Remove all stun tokens from one friendly model. Then you would deploy your models from... the training ground to there, and then once both of us have done it, you advance the moon tracker. It doesn't really matter. So you never have more than three cards. I'll just take an extra card.
Oh, can I draw? What can I draw a card for free?
Yeah, you draw a card.
Oh, okay.
Because you haven't got anyone to move from the healing house.
No.
So I discard my card. So I'm down to three. Remove the action tokens. You get to go first, sir. So we're about to see what combat does.
I will shoot you with my archer.
Okay. Who are you going to shoot?
This
that dude? Okay. Oh, yeah, because I'm out of range.
Yeah.
So, the way this works is Alan will create his attack pool, which would be his attack dice. So, you normally find with archers, it's they've got a lower stat, and
plus
then
two.
The action adds two. So, Alan's got plus two. My defense is three. Now, whoever has the highest number of dice left after the roll and eliminating dice, as you'll see in a moment, gets to choose. If there's a tie, the attacker gets to choose. So you'll see that if the attacker has equal to or higher, they always get to choose. So I've got Spirit, Void.
So
it's very lucky for me.
Cancel.
Yeah, so Spirit and Void's cancel.
So I'm the attacker, so I get to decide?
Yes, so basically you've only got Earth left, which is good, because it stuns me.
Stun you?
Yeah. When you're doing ranged combat, only two results normally work. That's Void, which is taken out of action as in injured, or
Earth,
which is a stun token. Any character that has three stun tokens, remember?
But I get
he's
air
also
as well.
Injured. But your special ability is that he could choose air if he had rolled it, and we'll worry about what that is later. So I put a stun token on my guy.
What does a stun mean?
If I get to three stun tokens, then I'll be out. But
okay.
I clear all stun tokens when I activate.
So. Yeah. So it's him activated.
Yep.
Sad panda.
Now, I'm going to regret this, but let's give it a go. So, I'm going to activate my tune-in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Move up.
Yep.
And attack. So, put the activated token next to him. Now, the tune-in has an attack of 3, but he gets a plus 1 for his Kaiken friend next to him, which makes it 4.
I have a defense of 1.
Which means I should, hopefully, not have too many of my dice cancelled out. So, your water cancels my fire. Yeah. But before we start, I have combat mastery, which allows me to reroll. It doesn't matter because I've got the void result. So here, I've got two voids and a spirit. So the void results will take him out injured straight away. The spirit result, will take out the defender straight away. The spirit result will take out the attacker, so I definitely don't want to use the spirit result. The fire and the water are cancelled, so I've only got really one choice, which is to put you out injured. Ka-ching! So I go up one. Yay! Well done, tune in. Your go, sir.
Good.
He's in range of your archer.
Yes, that's what I'm looking at.
Now, the interesting thing for Alan here is that because he's allowed to choose air as a result, air allows the attacker to move the defender up to three spaces. That's a big problem for me because he can pull my tune-in out into the open and then batter him with some other guys.
I'm going to shoot you.
Yep. So you get plus one stealth for goes. Stealth.
That's right.
Yep.
So I get four dice.
Cool.
Because I get one normally, plus two, plus coming out of stealth.
Yep, I have a defense of four. One, two, three, four. What I'm hoping to do here is to stop him getting a void. Right, we've got one void. I'm going to roll mine there. Brilliant. So my spirit cancels his void. I've got two voids. They're irrelevant. And an air that's irrelevant. Oh, my air cancels your fire. I can choose to make, during my turn, Spirit Mastery says any once per round after a model with this ability makes a roll, it may reroll any dice that did not show spirit. As I don't need the two voids, I'm going to reroll these two.
Okay.
Okay. Looking for...
Spirit won't help you though, because I don't cancel any of those out.
No, no. It's just because I didn't...
Oh, you get to reroll. Okay.
I'm not looking for spirits. I'm looking for...
No.
Fire?
No.
Yes. No, no, fire is water. No. Oh, poo. Yeah, so basically you're going to... Do you want to stun me or pull me three?
I'll pull you three.
That was not... Well, it's better than going out of action, I guess. So that was okay. And he's used that ability.
One, two, three.
Well, I can't do anything else with him. I can't hurt her. So let's go to there.
Mm-hmm.
And attack. My chap has two.
One.
Attack. Ooh, excellent. So I've got air and fire. And your void is fine. Air means I can move you three spaces. Fire. Yeah.
Means you move yourself. No,
the water, sorry. Player who picked the water result may move the attacker up to three spaces in any direction, defending player. Okay, yeah, that sounds fun. Okay.
Does move me in water count as two of the move? Or is that not the same?
One, two, three.
Okay.
Face you. Whenever you get to move someone, you get to face them wherever you want.
Oh, I'll do that then.
Yeah. I needed to stand him next to him so that if you go to run up and touch him, hopefully I can. Defend my boss. Sure go, sir.
Oh, no, you want
to... Yeah, you want to hit me in the back. You get plus one for hitting me in the back.
Yeah, but I'm trying to see because I can hit you back with this one.
Yes, if you face me that way, my back is there, there, and there.
Yeah, but I want to be outside. I don't want to be in this guy's influence. So I do put you that way.
Yeah.
And then bring some other things into it and then bring this in.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, we'll try that.
So I got rid of that stun token because I activated him.
Oh, no, it's better that way, isn't it? If I put you I'll put you that way.
Yeah, but you can run very far.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So I can run around you. Right.
Your go.
My go. That's an activate.
Ah. Clever. So you can come out of stealth if
you want. I'll take you.
Yeah, you might as well.
Might as well.
So you're going to get plus two. So you're going to be on five?
Yes. So yep. I have three plus two.
My defense is four. One, two, three, four.
Begun.
I'm going to play Mamoru, and it says, if a friendly model is defending and has a lower total defense than the attacker's total, which it does, play this card to add one.
Okay.
Think. So you still get to choose, but just increases the likelihood of me stopping you getting what you want. So let's cancel. I've got spirit. All right, let's just move that. So water and fire, yes. Air and earth, yes. And then air and no. So you've got these three to choose from.
Hang on a minute.
So you've got the choice of... Yeah. Currently.
No, that's fine. We can go. What are those?
So you've got a choice of water and
move me
air.
Or move
air
you.
Is to move me. And water is to move the attacker first and then I place myself.
I'll move you.
Yeah.
One, two... Three?
Yep. You've left me in a pickle, sir. In a right pickle. Yeah, let's do it. So this girl's going to stay stealthed.
Mm-hmm.
Is she? She can't get to you anyway. No, she doesn't. She's going to come out of stealth.
Mm-hmm.
She can't do what she needs to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take another movement. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Does it make dodge moves?
No, because you're stealthed.
Ah, okay, yeah, yeah.
So I'm using that to my advantage. And then 5, 6, 7, 8 to face that way.
Okay.
So the only back face. Oh no, I want to face this way, don't I? Because you've already activated. That way. Okay, that's his activation, that's her activation. Taking a massive gamble. Let's go!
So I'm going to do this one.
Yep. Okay.
1, 2. Come out and attack.
Attack! My defense is 2.
Mine, so I get
3 plus 1. Yep. Alright, anything that can help? No! Well, that's okay. So I've got that cancels that, which is good for you. And that earth cancels, yes, wind. So you've got water and earth. So you can stun me, or you can move you.
Myself, which is like a terrible idea. So I will stun you.
Yep. Ding. Stun me. Did moving her scupper some of your plans?
No.
Oh. Damn. I was hoping I'd done something useful.
Well, her field of influence is no longer relevant because he's taking
off. Yeah. I'll move Medushi to there.
Yep.
Face. That way? Corner ways?
That's there.
Oh, the dot's there, so. Next to corner.
Yeah.
My back arc is there.
Those three,
there.
Yeah.
And then I will use my Wanderlust on him to try and move him 4 spaces.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to roll at least 1 spirit. That's not it, but I will use my spirit mastery to reroll all the dice. Looking for 1 spirit. Yay! Got him.
Hang on.
So.
Wait.
It's not an attack, it's an ability. So I'm only going to move you around a bit.
Alright, go on.
I should be able to go 1, 2, 3, 4 to pop him to there. Facing that way. That's his front. Done, and he has activated. Your go, sir. If I've got that wrong, let me know.
Okay, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we are going to do that. And then we are going to shoot.
Yep. You on plus 1.
So that? So
4.
Yeah.
My defense is deuce. Okay. So void cancels spirit, which is irrelevant, and water cancels fire, which is irrelevant. So you've got the choice of the. You can stun me again to put another marker on me, 1 more and I'm out. Or you can move me around.
Stun you.
Yeah, I thought you might, because then you're a big guy and he needs to do a stun. Right. Well, I am going to. Move this guy up.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm.
And then make a blowpipe attack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Onto him.
Mm-hmm.
So 1, 2, 3 dice.
2 defense.
Cool. So. There we go. Nothing. Has no effect. Oh, but I rolled spirit, so you are poisoned. Ha ha ha. And that's him activated. There you go.
So I'm imagining.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
Isn't affected by the lanterns, it's on the floor.
They're all considered adjacent, so it's still affected by the lantern.
The magical lantern of everywhere.
Light goes up, mate. Light goes up.
It's got a hood on it. Ain't going nowhere. Alright, fine. So I'm going to go.
Yep.
Ugh. Come here. 1, 2, 3. 4.
Who stood? Oh, we weren't stood in the bush.
I was there.
Oh, okay.
1, 2, 3. 4, 5. 6.
Yep.
Shoot.
Yep.
So I get 4 attacks.
So I've got a defense of 2. Yay. So spirit cancels a void and water doesn't do anything. So you, air, that's your choice. So you get to move me 3 spaces.
Yeah, I'm gonna roll all of them.
Yep.
Stun you with that, is that right?
No, it's a range one, so only air, void, and earth count. So, yep, so you'll move me 3.
1, 2, 3, I think there's the best spot.
Cool. Yeah, cause you don't even have to necessarily worry about her getting. She just needs a stun.
Yeah.
That's all. Alright. Alright, in which case, my turn.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to play Vault. If any model moves to a space of elevated terrain, play this card to have the movement cost only 1 point. So I'll play on him. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Mm-hmm.
And he will attack from stealth. Your defense, sir?
My defense is 2.
Not what I was looking for. So air, spirit is not what I want. So none of these are cancelled. Oh, earth and air, yep.
So you can move me. So I or injure yourself.
You. Ooh. No, okay. No. So move you 3 spaces, is it? I get the feeling I'm going to get punched in the face by a Noonie now. So it's 2 against my 2. So you'll get to choose.
I'm taking from behind though.
3, sorry. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and +1 for your dude. So 4. That's not good. Ooh, that's interesting. So fire says all models in your influence zone are stunned, so you would take her out. Including the you. So basically you'd have stun you and him to take her out. And don't forget your clear stuns. You can choose to clear stuns later on.
Go on then.
Yep, that's a good choice. You gain 1 point. Ding, ding, ding. Yay.
Yay. Stun.
Right. In which case... Blink to there.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll shoot.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got an attack of 3. Your defense is 2.
Yeah.
Oh, main. Earth. So I stun you. Yep. Stunned. Didn't roll. Oh, and I rolled a spirit, so you're poisoned again.
I'll jump down. So I come out of stealth.
Yep. And so you're getting 6 to my 4.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Go on, get him out of the way. That's good. Ooh. So fire will stun her, him, and him.
That's that one. That one gets through. That one's that one.
Yeah.
That one's that one. So it's fire and water. Alright, I'll move myself 3 spaces.
Yep.
There.
Yep. And so then I will probably put myself there.
Yep.
Yep. Facing towards you. So I've got one dude left. Who will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to stand next to him, keep his stealth, and shoot you.
Okay.
So 1, 2, 3 against your 2. Da 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 dum! Here comes the poison dart of doom! Oh, you Rochambeau. Nothing. So you are poison! Oh no, I didn't even roll it, did I? Boo! Nothing. End of the round, we roll off to see who gets the initiative. I've got 1! I got 1! I've rolled more of yours.
1.
1, so roll again.
I rolled more of yours as well. None.
None?
None.
This is why you play rock, paper, scissors. Although, to be fair, that could go on a while too. I rolled one. Yay! I get initiative. Woo! So, remove all of my activation counters. And then move her from the healing house to the training house.
Yep.
Then redeploy her. I'm going to redeploy her over here. And then draw a card. Yeah, so none of mine have got stun tokens on them. That's fine. I'm going to go big. I'm going to go for pressure point. Because the moon is in its fiery zenith, I don't know. Give me plus two. So I'll be on 5, you'll be on 4. That means I'll get to pick the result. I'll attack your Uni! Uni man. Yes, so you get a fire result. Yep.
Is it attacking this one?
Yeah, the Uni. So you should be on.
So 3, 4.
Plus one for the guy behind
it. Yeah, 4.
Yeah. Right, 5. Ooh, that should do it. Oh, man. You have to roll so many spirits for. You've got a fire result. But I was the attacker, so that's okay. So I'm going to choose fire.
All models.
Yep.
So just this dude.
And me and the guy behind.
But he's not in his zone.
You are, influence. Back. You're in the back.
Was that zone of influence?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
So stun.
Dude's going to shoot you from behind.
Yeah. Got 4.
That's not good.
The stun's fine.
Oh, this is the attacker is stunned.
Yeah, no, but this is a stun. You just need to put stun markers on me. So, air and earth?
Yeah.
Air and earth.
No, I get, stunned.
Yeah, I'm looking at these thinking, do I want to re-roll now or later? It's only going to be one. I'll save it. It's fine. I'll take a stun marker.
He's on 2.
He's on 2. Save it when it matters.
He is activated.
He is activated. Pink. And then face.
I am resilient, don't forget.
That way. Well, I've got to do something.
Yeah.
No point attacking guys who are already activated. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. I think that should get you. So air and ground, water and fire. So I've got a void. So you get to take a test.
So I got a resilient roll, right?
Yes, so you make a resilient roll. You roll one die.
One die.
If you roll an air, it becomes a stun instead. Nope, he's taken out. Ka-ching! Well done, little man. Resilient doesn't feel as good as it should be.
No. One. Yeah. Swing.
Yep. Defense of 4.
So I have 3 attacks, plus 2 behind.
Yep. Okay. So, what? We've got a water on Earth. So fire, right, one sec. Well, I can't let you have either of those, can I? So I've got to re-roll these 3.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it's as good as dead anyway.
No, yeah, you've got 2 waters.
Which means you go out of action.
I'll reroll these.
Yep.
I've got action still. That's unbelievable.
Blink.
Okay.
My Uni hasn't gone this turn, has he? Oh, that's my man. I'm looking at him going, I can stab him in the back. No, it's my dude.
Stab him in the back. I've got no problem with that.
Going, oh my god. Right, let's shoot your Madushi in the back. He shoots him.
Mm-hmm.
Your defense of 2.
2.
Oh, I've got 1, 2. I'm shooting you in the back. 4. There's nothing.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Attack in the back. So, 2. Plus an additional, plus 2. He's got, so it's in the back, has attack of 2, plus a dude helping.
Then you get plus 1 for the back.
Oh, there's 1 for the back.
Yeah. Okay. What did we for? I've used my reroll, though.
That is ridiculous.
Man. Yep, so that cancels that. That cancels that. That Wind doesn't count. Water cancels that. Yeah, it's happened again.
Unbelievable. All right.
Oh, should you ever do that? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Earth and wind, so nothing.
Okay. Can I shoot?
Yep. You get to pick. No, I didn't get one. So I'm out. Bing. Yeah. Finally!
Get two.
So turn one. To face corner. Like that.
Okay.
And I hit you in the head. No. Double entendre. Reroll one of these. Yeah. Somewhat right anyway. Oh man. Fire. Doesn't help. Guess we're both getting stunned. Bonk and activate.
I'll activate him.
Yeah. quick!
What does the poison do again?
At the end of your activation, roll one die for each poison counter. On a water, you are stunned. On a spirit, you're out.
Yeah.
But I don't get any points for it.
Just do it. What's the worst that could happen? I die again? Oh, that seems very normal.
There you go. I need a spirit. Yay, you got it. Bing, and that cancels that, so you're left with air.
I'll move you.
Where would you like me, sir?
I'll go there.
So, sorry, I just need to place myself on your front, which is there. Ding. That's right, you're facing that way, is that right?
Or
which way?
That way.
That way. Oh, let's, oh, and roll two dice. Nothing, you're fine. Bing. Useful. You back. Facing that way. So I've got an attack of 3. Defense of 2.
Got defense of 1.
Oh, you're an archer. Oh, yeah, sorry. I thought he was a schnobble dude. Both stunned. I'm not going to take the other one, am I? Oh, that's it. Yeah. No, actually, don't lie. I'll reroll both of these. Take a risk.
What can you reroll?
Spirit Mastery.
Unbelievable. Right.
Sorry, I mean. Oh, darn it! Turnabout is fair play.
How many dice have you got?
I've got 3.
So I have 3, 4.
Yep. Is that right? No. 5. Because she's in my. Yeah, that's what we're looking for. Nope, fine, out. He takes the lead, he needs one more kill. Stop there. Stealth. And activate. And you'll go. If you can take this.
By the power of Grayskull!
Bring it.
So I get 4.
I've got 3.
Hang on, if I move, I can get you in the back here, I think.
Yeah, you can go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shoot me in the back.
Shoot in the back! So I get...
5.
3.
Oh, well, that's the one that matters.
Yeah.
Congratulations, sir.
The problem is mine were annoying. My deaths were annoying because I just rolled rally. You got greedy on 2 rolls and went, I'm doing it. Didn't work.
I got greedy on 1 roll. The other was just unlucky.
Yeah. Unlucky? I lost all of mine to unlucky rolls.
I didn't say there's any skill involved in that.
Oh. Right. Well, that was a lot of us staring at the board. Probably not you at all, which Dave will do some magic. Maybe put some fake eyes if I was looking over it so often.
I tried my best, but we'll just basically... We'll get, we'll get to the review.
High five.
So Alan won, so for now he gets to keep the Golden Ninja.
Wah.
And we're going to do our review on our 3P system and our geek rating out of 6. Alan's going to start.
So at the moment, I think it's actually a pass, but I think with some house ruling, it'll probably be a play. It's not. It's beautiful. The miniatures are beautiful, and you can see the whole idea and mechanic of everything. But there's too many random bits that can go wrong too quickly. That's where I'm standing. But I think that I probably would play it again. Maybe just to see if it was the same thing happened again. But you've played this several times now, I think.
Yes. So. Mine is a play, despite the fact that I own it.
Yes.
But it's definitely a play. I like playing it. I like the challenge of playing it. I think there are really good things about the game. The models are fantastic.
Yeah, they are. And this is just...
The quality of everything is really good. It's just that there's enough bits in there and the cost of it is high enough that I think if I had a choice between buying something like Descent or this, I'd go and buy Descent or Zombicide or, you know, the area of the market it's aiming for.
Yeah.
Given that you've got to buy the base game, which comes with only the base guys, and then these are all separate. By the time you add up all the cost of that, I think it pushes it into a play for me.
Okay.
Yeah. Out of 6, sir?
I am going to give it... it's a hard one, this one. Because it earns so many points in other ways, but loses them in lots of other ways.
Tell you what, you can split your review if you want.
No. Okay. I am going to give this, I'm going to give it 2.5. It's quite damning, I apologise for that one right now. I'm not quite sure it will split players 50-50, which is where the 3 would have been. I think it's going to be slightly swayed towards a certain style of player. I don't think there's enough in it. There's definitely not enough in it for Eurogamers, because there's too many dice rolls and way too random. And there wasn't lots of dice rolling which you felt you could affect, which I was having an issue with. It suffers from the same thing roughly as Blood Bowl does as well, with the dice being a real issue. The only upside is the fact that it's not everything ends when you fail.
Yes.
Like you lose that person's missed, had his turn, done.
And they come back very quickly.
They do come back very quickly, but it's only one a turn, right?
Well, you can have 2. You can choose not to draw a card and put 2 in. Oh. But yeah, in this situation, I've got 4, so I'm going to be 2 players down for the next turn. So you take a battering, and it does mean you take a battering.
Which are quite an even battering, though, to be fair.
Oh, another turn, and I would have died worse.
Yeah. But no, I think it's very close to being a 3. To be fair, like if I took the board and the game itself and what you've got here, it would probably be about a 5, because it is beautiful. Like, I'm not taking any of that away from the game whatsoever, but just the whole package with the gameplay element of it that we played to. Maybe we got some rules wrong, maybe you'll tell us we have and you'll explain we did something wrong in the wrong position, and you'll go, oh, actually this always happens when you do this because of that reason, then that'll maybe change when we play again. But at the moment, it's probably a 2.5. It's quite low, and I apologise for that. But for that's for the whole thing, not just the aesthetics of the game itself.
I'm going to give it 2 reviews, which comes as no surprise to them. I'm going to go on what I got as part of the Kickstarter and its potential, and just what you would get if you bought the base game.
Okay.
For the base game, I'm going to agree with you. 2.5. I think if you buy just the base game, the clans are so similar, and... the nice thing about what I've got is that each clan's completely different. They play in a different way. You can get behind the characters you really like. In the base game, they're very subtle differences. I mean, basically, you're rolling a different die for most of the time, and each Medusa's got a different skill. So most of your basic guys are going to be exactly the same. So it's going to feel very weird. And also, you're not going to get as many centuries and cool stuff. You're not going to get these lanterns and all those sorts of things. So for the base game, I'd say 2.5, because the investment to get it up to this level is a lot of money, and I think most people will be put off by that once they've played the game. That being said, if you are into this sort of amazing models and you love painting, and if you're more of a miniatures gamer, I think this is a great game for you if you can get over the Blood Bowl element of the dice just going against you. And to be fair, I've only played it with the kill team type, or the kill each other missions. There are some great missions in the book where you're going around getting each other's flags and all sorts. And 4 player, it's great that it expands to 4 players. Yeah. I think the carnage would be brilliant. You just see things flying off all over the place. And because you wouldn't be working to killing each other, you're working to missions, I think actually, and especially if you played it in teams where you were opposite each other, you could get some real fun bits. As I said, that's if you've invested in it. So if you've invested in it, I think it's going to be something like a 4.5 because you're into painting miniatures. You could spend ages making these all look lovely. You can go to the point of, you know, even building yourself some extra bits of terrain to go on there. Build your own maps even.
Yeah.
It's not that difficult. Just need some dots, and once you've got the terrain on there, you'll know what it is. So,
well, we spoke about just making the higher levels, maybe just one square higher with just some MDF or cardboard that you could then just go, oh, he is up one level. It's much easier to see.
Or a nice, if it had a nice embossed area on it so that there's a nice clean line between where you're going up and down. We got a bit distracted at times looking, going, well, so that's high, that's low. And it's a lovely gloss finish.
Yeah.
But under any sort of lighting, you're there going, what's that, moving your head around?
Well, obviously, and the little counters are really useful, but then they start getting in the way of the dots and when you're counting things and
spaces.
Yeah, well,
and then just trying to keep track of the is it Uni? I think that's the way they're pronounced. You can go onto their base, so that's fine.
Yeah.
But with the littler guys, you're there going, well, I want to move to that space, so I've got to move these around here. And
then you move the person and go, oh, I've got to move their things with them as well. And
In terms of mechanics, dice-wise, it's my big bugbear. I don't like the way the dice system is orientated towards fixed results because it adds that too much random element. I would prefer it if they had a simple chart for the winner. So you roll for your affinity and you get the number of results, whoever gets the most and wins, and the difference between your results goes on a simple little chart of 1, 2, 3. 1 being you get to move them 3 spaces, 2 being you get to stun them, 3 being you get to knock them out. And then you're looking at having as many dice as possible. You could still, basically, you're looking at 3 being the number you need to kill someone.
Okay.
So if you go in with only a couple of attacks, you know you're not going to kill them, but you could stun them or move them. So you've got guys with low attack ability, so they're thinking, well, if I can get in and do 1, I can move him into place. Then you've got some pushers and stabbers, and everyone then seems to have their own job.
Yeah.
Whereas as it is, you could have a really lucky 1 roll and knock out a really powerful character, or you could have 6 dice and end up dying yourself.
Yeah.
And that difference doesn't sit well with me, but that's what the game is in. We can always house rule it if we need to, but that's the only thing, which I'll get over. I never bothered me in Blood Bowl.
No, I love.
So yeah, I don't know why it bothers me now. Maybe it's been too long since I had to play a game with those mechanics. But yeah, that's the only thing. Other than that, I think the rest of it is lovely. So yeah, if you want to invest in it, you'll go well. And Alan is the winner.
Ninja Roll Stars go!
Pretty much our review.
If missing a geek, you know where to find us.
Bye.
Bye.
You're out. So